From the deposits of Tenke Fungurumu, Katanga Copperkiss into Mekonga, hand-sized specimens are pretty large. We have a matrix typical to that locality. This one is actually quite stable, so it's almost as if it's going into dolomite. And sitting on top of the matrix is a very, very thin crust of chrysocolla, which has been covered by a blanket of druzy quartz. Those little crystals you see here, let me see if I can zoom in a little bit closer. See if we can... Right. Those little crystals are druzy quartz sitting on there. And sitting on top of those druzy quartz crystals, I believe it's tiny vizygiarite crystals. Then when we turn the specimen this way over, we have a section which is purely pretty stable clay, come in this case going onto dolomite, also covered with a druzy quartz. The reddishness, most likely underlying, we have some heterogenite. From this side you just have the matrix, which is actually quite unusual to the matrix from Tenke, because this is almost solid dolomite, whereas usually it's almost a compacted clay. So it's different sections of the mine where you'd find different materials. Very aesthetic. How would I display it? Well, I would actually display it like this, where you have the crystalline quartz section over there, and then you have the druzy quartzes cutting the chrysocolla undertone over there. All from the deposits of Tenke Fungurumu, Katanga Copperkiss in the Congo.